Soon we'll to be riding on the showgrounds here. It's been a long time since the Speedway bikes have done it. Just to see Jason in action and the rest of the guys racing is quite good. We want to see the bikes out there more often.
Yeah.
But come out here today and check it out. We're also here tomorrow as well. It's fantastic. The arena's all been revamped and it's quite spectacular.
Troy Bayliss, great to see you in the promotion world, mate. And everyone looking forward to seeing the bikes light up the R&A showgrounds today.
Yeah, I'm gonna go get amongst it. I've got a bit of trust in these guys, so they know what they're doing. They've got better balance than me. I can only go fast.
Yeah. Oh, that's great to see. Thank you very much, Troy. And if you're keen to head out there, you'll find more information at troybaylisevents.com.
Yeah, come on out, guys. It's going to be incredible. Thank you.
All right. Good on you, Troy. Deb?
Good stuff. Looks like a fun day. Now, it's a family tradition that brings generations of Italians together. And now an annual event is getting everyone involved, celebrating the love of pizza and pasta. It's known as Saucy Sauce Day. And our Weekend Today producer, Angie Boustani, went along to learn about making the perfect Italian sauce.
Saucy Sauce Day!
A ton of tomatoes, some music, and a lot of laughter.
It reminds me of my time in Italy. The fun, the children, the noise, the music, the food, of course. Yeah, so great fun.
Sauce is the key ingredient in Italian cuisine. And this annual event is all about bringing its essence into everyone's kitchen.
Today you will go from being a saucy apprentice to being a sorcerer.
Founder of Saucy Sauce Day and the owner of Glenorie Bakery, Rob Pirina, says there's a lot more to it than just the sauce.
Well, basically, it is something that I started with my grandmother, who passed away last year. We started to teach the Australian people the art of Italian sauce making and basically how fun it can be to make Italian tomato sauce.
Did you grow up with Nonna making sauce every year?
I grew up around these beer bottles, not full of beer, but full of tomato sauce.
Yeah, the art of making traditional Italian sauce has been passed down from his Nonna, so it's fun. But you get very messy.
Today, a group of 60 are taking on the challenge to master the perfect sauce.
So I'm going to get involved today.
Yep.
Tell me where we have to start.
Well, first you've got to start with an apron. So we'll chuck that on you. Got that.
From cutting to blanching, then processing and bottling.
What do we put in the bottle before we put the sauce in?
Basil.
Just basil?
Basil. And we don't really season the tomato sauce at all. We allow the sauce to be a unseasoned base sauce, so whoever's cooking can add whatever they want to add into it.
While we break a sweat and make a mess, Uncle, or Zio Silvio, gets lunch ready and puts the sauce through its final stage.
Zio, tell me, what's happening in here?
We are pasteurising the tomato. It's in bottled, it's been sealed, and we bring it to the boil. We boil for about 10 minutes and then we'll let it cool down naturally, and it's good for 2 or 3 years.
After a long morning, it's finally time to eat.
There we go.
Thank you to you.
Buon appetito.
That's unfair, showing us that wonderful fare and not bringing it here. Beautiful. We can enjoy it later.
Maybe. Angie Boustani, great job. It's close to her heart, that Italian sauce.
We do it. Yeah. Love our nonnas. Now, coming up, we reveal the 60-second...